Industrial Revolution is a game for 2, 3 or 4 players with mixed strategy, overpowered cards and absurdity in equal proportions. You will try to be the first to build a star toy of our company, the Flamethrower. If you think that's crazy, you should know this has happened in real life. Seriously. To achieve it, you will only have to collect 3 parts with your workers and take them to your workshop. The first one to do it wins the game. However, if gathering parts seems too simple for you, you can also win the game by committing espionage. But let's go step by step. The game starts with 3 workers in each player's workshop. Whenever it's your turn, follow these 4 phases. First, draw 2 cards, one of each deck. The red deck contains cards designed to bug your opponents, and the blue one has cards designed to help you, which in reality can also be used to attack other players. This fact should give you an idea of how the game works. Second, roll the dice. The board has various squares with numbers and colors. Those are the pickup points, where resources appear from the storehouse. In this example, we look at those that have a 3, and put blue or red resources on them, as indicated by the 3 on each square. This way, new resources will appear in random places each turn, contributing to the general chaos. I will soon tell you what kind of resources there are, but let's move on. Third, move all your workers. Each one can move up to 7 squares, horizontally and vertically, but they cannot cross walls. When they reach a square with a resource, they can take it, and the resource will move with them. Resources can be released at any square, but if you do it inside your workshop, you will obtain the benefits from that resource. As in any other company, fights between workers are an important part of the manufacturing process. Therefore, whenever 2 or more workers coincide in the same square, they will fight, disappear from that square and reappear in their workshop. Fourth, move the conveyors. Before starting next player's turn, move everything on the conveyor belts. You can use them to travel through the factory, but their main goal is to slow down the movement of the workers. Resources. You already know you must deliver these 3 parts in your workshop in order to win, but there are some other type of resources that will give you other benefits. For example, delivering models give you permanent improvements until the end of the game, such as increasing the movement of your workers or protecting them from fights with a helmet. There are also resources that allow you to add extra workers to your team, and others that allow you to draw extra cards, although the most important one is the spy, since you can win the game by committing industrial espionage. When one of your workers saves this resource, becomes a spy. The spy must go to an enemy workshop to steal the secret documents, and if you're able to bring the spy back to your workshop with those documents, you win the game. The problem is that we're talking about a mediocre spy, which all players can see, so get ready to receive a bunch of cards from them. And speaking of cards, cards. Cards are the most important part of the game, as they allow you to unleash all your resentment on the other players. You can have up to 5 in your hand, and you can use them at any time, and I mean absolutely at any time. Even when another player is moving a worker, you can stop the movement at any square, and use the most wicked card you have. Do all kinds of evil with your cards, like bribing enemy workers, shooting them with a circus cannon, forcing your workers to work overtime, or, naturally, using the flamethrower, since we are building them. Those are just some examples, but our R&D team has worked really hard looking for original methods so you can annoy your friends. All these elements make Industrial Revolution a game so exciting that you won't want to get up from the chair, so as not to lose any opportunity to annoy your friends. By the way, 4-player games can also be played in pairs, in case you want to collaborate. But to be honest, in the end that means a player less to ruin with the cards, so up to you.